Okay, so in yesterday's class, we also started with the curing of concrete. So as I told you, that is to attain a sufficient hydration of a cement particles. That is what the reaction between the water and cement, a curing will be carried out. Okay, and types of curings or method of curings is broadly classified into four types or four methods. That is water curing, membrane curing, application of heat, and some other types of curing which comes under the miscellaneous. And also we studied the graph. So first one, that is the water curing, which is the far best method of curing, as it satisfies all the types of requirements, that is promotion in the hydration, then if any shrinkages are there, cracks are there, that can be eliminated, then if there is a generation of heat, that can be absorbed by the water. Okay, so if you see the some pictures, that is the curing, water curing can be done either by immersing the concrete specimens in the water, or by ponding process, or by spraying and fogging process, or by wet covering process. Okay, so these are the some of the methods in where the curing will be carried out by the water curing. So actually what happens in this water curing is that whatever the external applied water it is there, it will be on the top surface of the concrete. So this water, what is present inside the concrete, will remain as it is. Only this, the external or extra water, whatever it is there, that will be evaporated, so that the hydration will be maintained inside the concrete. Now another method of the curing of concrete is membrane curing. Okay, so sometimes what happens is the concrete works are carried out in the places where is the acute shortage of water. Okay, normally in the places where the water is sufficiently available, you can directly go with the water curing. But in, at the some places, at the, that is a hot condition places, the high heavy cement condition places, there is a very much shortfall of the water. Okay, so in order to overcome this shortage of water, we can go with another type of curing, that is a membrane curing. So here, the quantity of water normally mixed for making the concrete is more than sufficient to hydrate the cement, and also provides this water not allowed to go out from the body of concrete. So the this type of membrane or this type of curing, what it does is it will not allow the water to go out from the body of concrete, and the concrete could be covered with the membrane, which will be effectively seal off the evaporation of water from the concrete. So here what happens is, whatever the concrete surface is there, it will be covered by a very thin sheets, okay, without adding or without providing any external source of water. Only the sheets will be provided on the surface of a members, concrete members. Okay, so what happens is that whatever inside water is present, it will not allow to get evaporated. Now the curing compounds are the liquids which are usually sprayed directly onto the concrete surfaces, and which then dry to form a relatively impermeable membrane that retards the loss of moisture from the concrete. So what will be done exactly is, a thin plastic sheets or any other types of sheets will be covered on the concrete members, and above that a curing compounds in the form of the liquids, okay, are used and will be sprayed on the sheets. Okay, so they form a very impermeable membrane that will not allow any moisture to get retired from the concrete. So you can see the pictures here. So this is where the concrete has been laid and compacted, and above it a sheets will be applied, and like such plastic sheets will be applied, and on that you can see this is the uncovered concrete and this is the covered concrete, and on that again a water, a liquid spray will be provided, okay, or will be sprayed. Such a liquid you can see here, such type of liquids, white liquids which are available, they can be either sprayed or painted through a brush, or if it is for the flooring, such liquids are available directly, you can wash it to the floors. Okay, so before I go for the next type of curing, I want to show exactly how membrane curing is been carried out through a video. Okay, so just I'll stop sharing this. Please wait for a while, I'll share the screen. I think the screen is visible, so I'll start playing the video so you can just watch it. If the audio is not audible, then please let me know. Okay.
Membrane curing of concrete. In some places, where there is an acute shortage of water curing may not be possible for reasons of economy. We know that curing of concrete is done as water added in the concrete gets evaporated after being placed. If water curing is not possible, covering with a membrane will effectively seal off the evaporation of water from concrete. However, a small amount of water is sprayed before covering with the membrane. There are a large number of sealing compounds developed in recent years. Some of the common materials used are bituminous compounds, polyethylene or polyester film, waterproof paper, rubber compounds, etc. So initially, the bituminous compound was being used for this purpose. As bituminous compound is black in color, it absorbs heat from the concrete when converted to the top surface of the concrete. This results in the increase of temperature in the body of concrete, which is undesirable. Thus, other modified materials which are not black in color came in use. However, bituminous compound coated with lime is being used as lime wash prevents heat absorption. To obtain best results, a small amount of water is sprayed before covering with the membrane. Normally, 2 or 3 coats may be required for effective sealing of the surface to prevent the evaporation of water. The reason for large use of membrane curing is due to increase in volume of construction, shortage of water, need for conservation of water, increase in cost of labor, and availability of effective curing compounds. Membrane curing is commonly preferred for curing canal lining, sloping roofs, and textured surface of concrete pavements. In case of waterproofing paper or polyethylene film are used as the membrane, sufficient care must be taken to see there is no puncture. In membrane curing it should be checked that whether adequate lapping is given at the junction and these laps are effectively sealed. Thank you for watching. Stay.
So I hope at least some part you understood what is the reason for membrane curing. So usually I think in the smart city work, the road construction, what you've seen, all the curing was covered with the membrane curing only. Okay, a thin polythene sheets were used once the concrete is placed and compacted, and it will be allowed for at least 1 week for the curing purpose. Okay. Now moving ahead, let's see the another type of curing. So again, I'll share the screen. So I think you understood where the membrane curing will be carried out. That is for the canal lining and for the sloping roofs and also for the pavements. Okay. So especially we are going to use some compounds such as bituminous or plastic sheets, okay, or any other type of chemicals for the floors. Okay, now moving ahead, the another type of the curing of concrete is application of heat. Okay, so but as we know, in the previous cases, how the water will get evaporated because of the high temperatures, that is if it is directly exposed to the sun. But the same heat by applying to the concrete, I can cure the concrete. So let's see how it is. So whenever the concrete is subjected to the higher temperatures, it accelerates the hydration process, resulting the faster in development of strength. Okay, now actually if you know, that is the hydration, that is the chemical reaction between the cement and water, is increased if I increase the temperature. Because higher the temperature, the more will be the reaction and more will be the hydration. Okay, so more the hydration, at no time the concrete develop its strength. Okay, so usually the concrete will develop its strength because of the hydration process. Okay, so therefore subjecting the concrete to higher temperatures and maintaining the required wetness can be achieved by subjecting the concrete to steam curing. Now, the exposure of concrete to higher temperatures is done in the following manner. That is how the concrete can be exposed to the higher temperature apart from the directly exposing to the sun. That is, steam curing can be carried out. One is at the ordinary pressures or at the high pressures. And also the curing can be carried out by the infrared radiations, or sometimes you can go with the electrical curing also. Okay. So it depends again the type of the work which you are going to carry out and what are the availability necessary of this type. Now how actually it was in carried out is a faster attainment of strength will contribute to many other advantages mentioned below. Okay, so not only it increases the strength by increasing the temperature, but some of the again few properties can be changed. The concrete is vulnerable to damage only for short time. Okay, so because if you see, if the curing is not done correctly, you can see the many number of cracks. Because of that, the shrinkage and creeps will start generating. Okay, so that can be avoided by adopting the such type of curing method. Concrete member can be handled very quickly. So if you want to use any structure in a short time, so usually as per the standards, what it says is the minimum requirement for the curing is 7 days for any type of structure. Okay, so but if you want to overcome that time, if you want to use a structure in short time, then you can use some of the other types of curings, and that one is the application of heat. Then for this, a very small curing tank is sufficient to cure the structures. Then the work can be put onto the surface at very early time. As I told you, in no time I can use the structure. Then if it is a pre-stressing bed, can also be released early for the further casting. Okay, so if your structure is of the pre-stressing type of structures, that is usually the stresses will be generated or allocated before actually the load is applied. Okay, especially in the construction of bridges and dams, you can see the pre-stressing concepts. So there the curing can be, this type of curing can be carried out. Then a fewer number of formworks will be sufficient, or alternatively with the given number of formworks, more turn will be achieved. Okay, so usually formwork is required while the casting and placing of concrete. So if you are going to adopt a application of heat curing, in no time you can cure the concrete. So in no time you can build the other part of structure. Okay, so for that reason, formwork can be in fewer number, or whatever the available, in only in that only you can manage the things. Okay, so let's see some of the types of curing under this one. As I told you, steam curing at ordinary pressure. Now here what will be done is a steam will be applied on the in situ construction, that is on the site which are casted there only, will be a very much sometimes it will be a little difficult task to carry out such type of curing. However, at the some places it has been tried for in situ construction by forming a steam jacket with the help of the tarpaulin or a thick polythene sheets. So the picture you can see here, especially the inside a concrete member is there. So on that concrete member, a thin polyurethane sheets or a steam jacket will be covered, and a steam will be given inside. Okay, so little difficult task it is, but you can still manage if the structures are in situ, means there only they are builted and casted. Okay, so you can see the graph here. Usually the how the strength can be increased in the period of time. So around 100% of the strength can be achieved at 28 days itself, and at what temperature, that is very important. So if as and if you increase the temperature, you can see that in no time you are getting more strength. Okay, Because if I go with only 21 degree Celsius, that is this graph, 21 degree Celsius, I'm getting the 80% strength at 14 days. At 14 days, as well, whereas for the 46 degree Celsius, that is an increased temperature, I'm getting the 80% strength at 5 to 6 days only. See how much reduced, how much time I can reduce. Okay, for that reason, we are going with the such type of curings. So another one is high pressure steam curing. It is something more different from the ordinary steam curing, in that the curing is carried out in a closed chamber. Okay, whereas in this, it was been carried out in the open site, but this type of curing will be carried out in the closed chamber. High pressure steam cured concrete develops in 1 day or less than strength as much as the 28 days strength of the normal cured concrete. So please look at this sentence, read it one more time. I'll read it. High pressure steam cured concrete develops in 1 day or less the strength as much as the 28 day strength of the normal cured concrete. Okay, so whatever you carry out the curing, normal curing, whatever the strength you'll get after 28 days, the same strength can be achieved in 1 day itself. Then high pressure steam cured concrete exhibits higher resistance to sulfate attack, freezing and thawing, action and chemical actions, and it also shows the less efflorescence. So apart from the curing, it also resists some of the properties, that is sulfate attack can be avoided, then freezing and thawing action, that is increase and decrease in the atmosphere temperature, that attack can be avoided. Then chemical actions, if there are there on the concrete, they will be not get penetrated inside, and also there will be no efflorescence, that is change in the color in the concrete. Okay, so here you can see a picture. These are all the precast members, already casted members, so they will be taken inside this closed chamber and the heat will be applied in a high pressure. So such type of curing we call it as a high pressure steam curing. Okay, so such cast cured members exhibits very much lower drying shrinkage and moisture movement. Okay, almost there is just zero moisture movement whenever it is exposed in or directly to the sun after the curing. Whatever the moisture it is there inside the concrete, it will remain as it is without getting evaporated. Now in the high pressure steam curing, concrete is subjected to a maximum temperature about 175 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to a steam pressure of about 8.5 kg per square centimeter. So for this degree of temperature, you can get a steam of 8.5 kg per square centimeter of a specimen. Then another type of the curing by heat is the infrared radiations. So such type of curing is usually practiced in very much cold climatic regions, especially in the Russia. It is claimed that much more rapid gain of strength can be obtained than with the steam curing, and that rapid initial temperature does not cause a decrease in the ultimate strength as in the case of the steam curing at an ordinary temperature. Now by this type of curing, what I can get is whatever the strength is gained, rapid strength in no time, there is no much difference or decrease in the ultimate strength as I got from the steam curing at ordinary pressure. That is, if you cure a concrete with an ordinary pressure and if you cure a concrete with infrared radiations, one is you can get a curing in no time, and obviously there is no decrease in the ultimate strength. Usually what happens is, whenever if the water gets start evaporating, ultimate strength may decrease at the end, but that can be avoided by carrying out the curing it by infrared radiation method. This type of the curing is mostly often for the hollow concrete products. Okay, so if the hollow concrete products such as the pipes, concrete pipes, shells which will be used for the construction, so those such type of the membranes or members can be cured using infrared radiation systems. So this picture you can see here, a infrared radiations or waves will be generated, and you can see here, so it will be applied on the concrete member. So this infrared waves, what they will do is they will penetrate inside the concrete members. So those waves will generate the heat inside the concrete and they maintain the heat of hydration rate in the concrete. Okay. Then another type of the curing here is electrical curing. So the concrete can also be cured electrically by passing an alternating current, that is electrolysis trouble will be encountered if the direct current is used through the concrete itself between the two electrodes either buried in or applied to the surface of the concrete. Okay, so if the concrete structures are there like beams and columns where it is not possible to go with the water curing or any other type of curing, even by passing the electrical current, alternating electrical current, we can cure the concrete. Okay, so the two electrodes which will be used, they will be connected on the both the sides of the structure, either inside buried or on just surface of the concrete, and the current will be passed. But only thing is that care must will be taken in order to prevent the moisture from going out, leaving the concrete completely dry. So what happens is, as the current speed will be very much more compared to the other types of curings what we studied, so in no time the moisture will be get exposed it. So that care we have to take, that a moisture, complete moisture will not go outside the concrete, making it fully dry. Otherwise what happens is, again there will be a chances of shrinkage and creep in the concrete. So you can see here, if this is a concrete structure, so on the surface of the structures you can see this electrodes. Electrodes are nothing but the steel rods will be there, steel rods above that, and a charge will be applied, okay, through which the current will be passed.